Hello, we are Group 10, consisting of Lucas Haas and Richmond Liang, and this is our object-oriented shopping cart program, Vapor, which is a video game merchant. So looking at the login screen here, we have the option to register or log in. I'm going to show you an invalid login first, and if we hit register here, we have the option to create both customer and seller users. So I'm going to create a second seller account because I created one earlier for testing. So we'll go ahead and register. Okay, so that brings up a new JFrame that shows us our inventory list. And in this list, we can see the game title, the last purchase price, quantity, and sell price. This list is sorted, and it's also sortable by these radio buttons up top, by ID, name, purchase price, sell price, and quantity. The cost, revenue, and profit are also visible on the top right over here by simply hovering over the words. And we can see right now that value is 8,300. We're going to take note of that because when we add a new item to this list, it will update that value. So I'm going to use the Add New Product button over here on the top left. And this brings up a new JFrame that allows us to add item details. So the list has now been updated, and if we look over here on the cost, you can see that the price has changed as well. Now, taking a closer look at our inventory list, we can see that there are three buttons here. The first button, Buy, will allow us to purchase new items for our inventory, and we can update the purchase price. So let's say I got this new one for $20, and I'm buying 10 more. So we can see that, these numbers right here will be updated once I hit submit. Okay, so now if we look at the info edit button, that's going to bring up the same JFrame that we used to create the item originally, and this just simply lets us edit what we already created. And if we go to remove, I'm going to remove this demo item right here, and you can see it just gets removed from the list altogether. And that concludes the seller side of our program. And continuing on to the customer side, we get the same familiar item list in this new JFrame with a lot less details though. We can see the inventory count, we can see what is in stock, and the sell price of the item. And looking at the top bar over here, we are able to see that we have zero items in the cart, the value of the shopping cart is zero, and we can once again sort this list by either name, price, or quantity. So taking a closer look down here, we can use these buttons or type in the number to choose the amount of items that we're going to add to our cart. So I'm going to add 3 copies of this one, 5 copies of Civilization, and 2 copies of Metal Gear. Okay, so now you can look at the top bar here and we can see that we have 10 items in our cart and our value has updated as well. I'm now going to click Open Shopping Cart, which will bring up a new JFrame and give us the option to manipulate our shopping cart before we check out. We have an option to clear our shopping cart right here, obviously check out, see the total value, and manipulate individual items if we want to, you know, reduce one item or just remove the item altogether. And you can see that the total updates down here on the top, on the bottom left. And once we are all ready to go, we hit checkout. We get a confirmation asking us if we really want to check out, and it shows us that we have now paid and we owe $0. And that concludes the demo for Vapor Video Game Merchant.